Okay, a quorum being present, the meeting will come to order. If we would stand and salute the flag first, please. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. To either of the constables of the town of Brookfield and the county of Worcester, greetings. In the name of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, you are hereby directed to notify and warn the inhabitants of said town qualified to vote in town affairs to meet at the Brookfield Elementary School, 37 Central Street, Brookfield, Mass., on Tuesday, November 15, 2016, at 6:30 p.m. to act in the following articles. And you are directed to serve this warrant by posting up attested copies thereof at the town hall and post office in said town 14 days at least before the time of the holding of said meeting. Hereof, fail not and make due return of this warrant with your doings thereon to the town clerk at the time and place of the meeting. Given under our hands this first day of November in the year 2016. Stephen Comptoir, Linda Lincoln Selectman. A true copy attest. Pursuant to the within warrant, I have notified and warned the inhabitants of the town of Brookfield by posting attested copies of the same at the U.S. Post Office on Tuesday, the first day of November 2016, and at the Brookfield Town Hall on the same day. 14 days before the date of meeting as directed within, Richard LaPierre, a true copy attest, Michael Siri, town clerk. Do we have any people in here who are not registered voters in Brookfield? Okay, I can keep an eye down here. That it? Okay, good. Anyone wishing to speak tonight, if you'd go up to the microphone, first time you speak, if you would give your name, first and last name, that would be fine. Remarks should be addressed to the moderator. We don't have anybody standing, I'll take care of that. Just want to go over two things. Sometimes things move along quickly, sometimes they drag. I think tonight will move quickly. But if we have something that's dragging and someone gets up to move the question, that means they want to end debate. People that are lined up at the microphone get to speak, but that's it. So if somebody gets up, moves the question, and there are two people behind him or her, those two people will speak, and then that's it. It'd be too late to come up and say something at that point if the motion passes. Now, if the motion doesn't pass and you want to continue debating, then we'll go on. Other than that, I think we're ready to go. Article 1.
Mr. Moderator?
Well, let me, don't rush me.
Well, before Article 1?
Oh, okay, yep.
I'd like to move to allow the town accountant and town treasurer to speak this evening.
Second. Motion made and seconded to allow the town treasurer and the accountant to speak. They're not residents of Brookfield, that's why we need that motion. All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Okay. Anything else?
That's it, thank you, sir.
Okay. Article 1. To see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate, transfer, or borrow a sum of money to repair the Dunbrook Bridge on Quaybog Street, or take any action relative thereto.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
I move that the town vote to transfer the sum up to $105,300 from stabilization to repair the Dunbrook Bridge on Quabog Street.
The motion, you need to get rid of up to.
So, would you like me to read it again, or?
Well, I'll accept that as a friendly motion.
Okay.
Did someone over here say why?
Mm-hmm.
Sure. You have to have a specified amount. If they don't transfer that money, then it's not transferred. But we need the upper limit of it as a number. So his motion is to move to transfer the sum of
$105,300
from stabilization to repair the Dunbrook Bridge. Okay, questions? We need to come on up and let's get started.
Mary Lou Knight. Mr. Moderator, it would help to have some financial information from the accountant. How much is currently in stabilization, and where are we with budget to levy limit, and what's in Chapter 90?
Did the advisory committee want to speak to this now, or?
Yeah, I will. Right now we have $630,000 in stabilization. Chapter 90, we just got a fresh batch and it hasn't been touched as far as I know, and that's $168,000. We're about $272,000 below the levy limit right now. So those are some of the key figures to bear in mind when we're doing this.
What was the last one?
$272,000 below the levy limit.
Okay, other questions, comments?
Yeah, I think so.
If we're 200, and, or Trudy O'Connell, if we are $272,000 below the levy limit, why don't we raise and appropriate this amount?
Who wants to? Somebody want to answer this one?
I'll give it a shot.
Okay.
We discussed this quite lengthily about the Chapter 90 money. Right now, there's a fresh batch coming in. It's 168, so we thought we could use that. That's what the money is there for, and that's we decided to take 105 out of the 168. You want the other side? Well, we're trying to keep the taxes down, and we do not want to go over the levy. We want to stay below that. We're in good shape right now. Staying below that number.
Could I ask someone to explain the plan?
Sure, identify yourself.
I'm not really clear as
Mr.
to
Mr. Cook, what, identify yourself.
Okay, it's James Cook, and I'll lead the selectman advisor. Could you explain the plan? Are we planning to take some money out of the stabilization, some money out of the highway chapter money to build the entire amount? What's the plan?
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
The plan that we have now currently is the high mark that our highway department's stating is that project's going to cost $210,600. Nobody in the highway department or this board feels is going to come to that amount. We haven't really gotten even a true estimate from two people that we've gone out to bid. It's pretty much changing every week. Unfortunately, dealing with the state is a hard thing to do. If anybody out there has not heard the news that the state finally allowed us to open the bridge to a one-lane bridge, which is great. The Board of Selectmen was actually going to meet, we did meet this evening, and we were going to take a vote to open it before the state allowed us to. That's how upset we were with the state. But the repair is going to come, obviously, at an expense. We're not going to replace the whole bridge. We're going to encase the rotten piers with fiberglass, and $105,300 of that $210,600 would be coming out of Chapter 90 money. If that does not cover it, then we're looking to stabilization to cover the rest.
All right, anyone? Somebody else down here? Yeah. Clarence, go ahead. Mr. Snyder, go ahead if you want.
Yeah, I just back to the original plan, and there's Clarence Snyder. The original plan was, and what the state was requiring, is an elimination or replacement of the bridge. And so that the estimate, and Herb's back there, and if Herb wants to speak to it better than I, probably he is better at this than I, but the first estimate from College Engineering was the $210,600. And I know he's shaking his head in the right direction, so I know I'm moving in the right direction. In the meantime, Cindy and Herb identified another source of supply, which goes back to the idea that Steve was talking about of securing the piers. the outside piers, with the piers that are rotted. The fortunate thing is that through Herb and Cindy's work, we're now able to have the single lane bridge because it was the center supports are good. So the point of this motion is to go forward with the idea that we would like to get it for some $90,000. And again, I'll look to Herb to see if he's shaking his head in the right direction. That the $90,000 would be that could secure the outside piers and put the bridge back to normal. And so with that, what this motion allows us to do is to kind of take those next steps as we listen and understand whether or not a grant that we've applied for would in fact cover the whole bill. Herb, did I get that right?
Yes.
Thank you.
Bless you.
Just Peter O'Connell, what is our free cash situation? That was one figure you didn't mention. But we still have free cash for 16, do we not?
I think we used it.
I think it was right down to $1,000, if I remember right.
Okay. And then why is it that we're not borrowing this money? If instead of taking it out of stabilization, and then if we get grants or it doesn't come to so much and blah, 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 then it's going to mean would it not mean that we'd have to vote to put it back in stabilization a year from now or next spring? Why don't we just borrow the money?
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
I can only speak for myself. Mr. O'Connell, borrowing comes with interest, comes with time. We need to get this fixed. We need money to allocate for it. Again, I don't think it's going to come to the fact that we even have to touch stabilization with our Chapter 90 and grants and Herb and Cindy's diligent work on not only looking for other contractors. I think we're in a good position.
Anyone else?
Nancy Mannix. I live on Henry Allen Ave. Just a question. You're going to open it with one lane. Is it going to be a temporary thing? Is it going to close again? Are you going to be able to leave that open while you're working on it? And are you going to be working on it before the winter?
I would ask Mr. Chafee to answer that question.
At this point again, with the bridge being open,
Mr.
I know everybody can hear me.
Oh, yeah. You're coming in loud and clear.
With the bridge right now, it's going to be open temporary for a single lane bridge to let people back and forth. When we get a contract in town and everything to get the bridge repaired, it's going to be closed for that period of time while they're working on the bridge.
Do you have any estimate of the time it's going to be closed again? I mean,
we haven't even gone out for contract. We haven't got money to go out for contract. That's why we're here tonight.
So all I want to know is this going to go all the way through the winter?
Yes. Simple question, yes.
It's going to be a temporary bridge?
No, it's going to be a single lane bridge through the winter.
Through the winter?
Most likely, yes.
Okay, so at least we're going to have that access.
I'm hoping so. Whether or not if the state, I'm back and forth with the state today trying to get them to give me the okay to take the other two Jersey barriers out of the way. They are holding us up.
I don't ever hear anything. I don't, I have to go all around even to get here tonight, I mean, it's just a constant. I just don't want to see us all through the winter. It's going to be even worse.
We're with you. We were going to open it this evening. State beat us finally to the punch. We're going to have to play their game, unfortunately, now. And I would assume that we'd probably fix it in the spring.
Well, according to the two people that we've talked to from Oregon and from Massachusetts here that do the repairs on the pilings underneath, they can do it through the winter, providing that it's not below 0 degrees.
Well, Oregon's not qualified, correct?
That's correct. So we're going to be probably using the outfit out of Hudson, Mass. That does that type of work in Massachusetts, and they're already certified for the state of Mass.
Before we keep, please keep addressing your questions up here, because although this discussion is okay, there are others that get into this situation that don't turn out so neat. So,
well, I'm just trying to get a picture of what it's going to be like. Are we going to be just temporary, and then all of a sudden you're going to close it again, and you know, I don't know. I guess you don't know either.
What?
I just wanted some direction. I try to ask questions when I'm, you know, like I'm at the town hall and everything, and I get 50 million different answers. So I thought, you know, maybe tonight we could get some sort of. So you're telling, are you really telling me that you're going to open the bridge this Thursday?
No. Don't look at me.
Don's coming out himself.
Well, you said to me, you told me to ask you the questions. I'm asking you.
Mr. Chafee, go see what you can do.
As of right now, I'm waiting for the state to call back and say it's okay to open up. I'm getting very, I'm going to try to be political here, irritated. And by this Friday, as far as I'm concerned, the bridge is going to be open. Because I am tired of it and everything else. We're supposed to have some type of weather coming in Monday, so I don't want to have to deal with trying to get around it as well. So as far as I'm concerned, it's going to be open by this Friday.
Okay. And then we're going to work on the rest of it to get it actually.
Once the bridge is open, we get a contract signed and everything else to get the physical work done on the bridge. When the contractor tells me they're going to be coming out, we're going to notify everybody, like they do through town, that the bridge is going to be closed for this period of time while they're doing the work on the bridge. Because if they have to deal with traffic, it's going to take 3 to 4 times longer. It'll be quicker for them to just close it, go down there, and just do the work.
Oh, yeah. If I could see the light at the end of the tunnel, I'd be real happy. You
know. There's light, man.
Thank you.
All right.
Before you go, Mr. Chafee, so assuming that you get the money tonight and things move along and you put the bid out, when is your best guess as to when work would start?
It's going to take, how long does it take to do a contract and bid package? It takes at least a month anyways. So you're looking at first of the year.
Good. Okay. Any other questions before he goes back?
Yep. Marie Picor. Mention was made of coating the beams in fiberglass.
That's correct.
And I'm just wondering, why would we not just replace them instead of coating a decayed piece of whatever with fiberglass?
They are replacing the ones that are rotted. They're cutting the sections out, and they're going to put them back together, and they're going to fiberglass them off. That's the standard operating procedure they do all through the country.
So they're going to replace the decayed part?
Yes.
With a new piece, but and then encase it all in fiberglass?
Encase all of them in fiberglass.
Yeah, okay. All right.
Anything else before? Yep.
What's the weight limit going to be?
That I cannot tell you.
What about Friday?
Friday what?
14. What will the weight limit be Friday?
14 tons.
Any other questions before he gets to sit down again? Okay, thank you. Anything else? Okay. All those in favor of transferring the $105,300 from stabilization will say aye in a minute, and those opposed, no. I need a two-thirds vote. So let's see how we do this the first time. All those.
Can I say something?
Yeah.
Hey, Herb, do you have a, did they give us some kind of a rough estimate, like 90 or 100 to do this procedure rather than the 210?
At this point of game, it's a ballpark.
Okay. But what we're going to try to do is use the Chapter 90 money first and not the stabilization, because I'm a bug on taking money out of there too. But we just want to make sure we have money on hand quickly if we need it to get the bridge paid for and done. And that's one of the reasons we're going this avenue.
Don't forget, we got other things to fix in town too in Chapter 90. So.
Okay. All right, let's just go with this. All those in favor of transferring the $105,300, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, no. Would you show that that's unanimous? Okay. Article 2. To see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate, transfer or borrow a sum of money to replenish the road reconstruction account for money spent on the Dunbrook Bridge on Quaybog Street or take any action relative thereto.
Mr. Moderator?
Yep.
I move that the town vote to transfer the sum of $23,200 from the stabilization account to replenish the road reconstruction account for money spent on the Dunbrook Bridge on Quaybog Street.
Motion made and seconded. Any discussion on this one? Hearing none, we need a two-thirds vote again. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, no. Would you record that that was unanimous? Article 3. To see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate, transfer or borrow a sum of money to pay an invoice for FY 2016, or take any action relative thereto.
Ms. Moderator. Good. Good to go. I would move that the town vote to transfer $106,013.13 from the FY municipal gas account to pay an invoice for FY 16. Thank you.
Motion made and seconded to transfer
$1,006.13, please. Sorry about that.
That's all right. Okay. Any discussion on this one?
I'll just mention that an invoice from Dennis K. Burke Company in the amount of $1,006. Maybe you got to get somebody else up here. Anyway, that's the next election. Anyway, for gas purchased from the municipal gas account, this invoice was received October 4th, 2016. A late invoice.
All right. Any discussion?
Yeah, get me off the hook.
You're paying attention anyway, so you notice the difference between $1,000 and $100,000. Okay, this one requires a 9/10 vote. So let's see how we go with this one if there's no discussion. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, no. Record that as unanimous. Article 4. To see if the town will vote to transfer a sum of money from the health agent administration account to the Board of Health secretary account.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes, sir.
I move that the town vote to transfer $1,000 from the health agent administration account to the Board of Health secretary account.
Second.
Motion made and seconded. Any discussion on this one?
Explanation?
Who wants to try and explain this one?
Who had the question?
Mr. O'Connell.
The secretary is going to be taking over these duties.
Okay. Anything else? If not, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, no. Okay, that's voted. Unanimous again. Article 5, to see if the town will vote to transfer the sum, a sum of money from the elections expense account to the assistant town clerk's account. Who's got this one?
I do.
Mrs. Lincoln?
Yeah, Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
I move that the town vote to pass over this article.
Second.
Motion made and seconded to skip over this article. All those in favor of passing it over, say aye.
Aye.
No? Opposed? Okay, we're on to the next one. Article 6. To see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate, transfer or borrow a sum of money to pay a bill from a prior fiscal year.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes, sir.
I move that the town raise an appropriate $5,250 to pay a bill from a prior fiscal year.
Second.
Thank you.
Okay.
And again, this is the Again, this is the gas company that chose not to bill us until February of 2016.
All right. Just a second. Motion made, seconded to raise and appropriate $5,250 for prior year's bill. Okay, who? Yes, go ahead.
Do we know if any money was returned back to the town last year in this department? Returned back to stabilization or free cash?
Nothing's been transferred yet, but there's roughly $460 still in the account from 2016.
Okay. Right, thank you.
Any other questions? It's a prior year bill. We need a 9/10 vote on this one. All those in favor of raising and appropriating $5,250 for this bill, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, say no. That's unanimous. Article 7. To see if the town will vote to transfer a sum of money from the election expense account to the assistant town clerk wages account or take any action relative thereto.
Mr. Moderator.
Mr. Comptoir.
I move that the town transfer $2,400 from the election expense account to the assistant town clerk wages.
Second.
Thank you. Okay, motion made and seconded. Discussion, questions?
How come?
There's new laws that take into effect for public record requests, and the town clerk is requesting more time to fulfill those requests in a timely manner, which is going to take clerical hours.
So that person's going to get
up. No, never mind.
So that person's going to be spending more time there when Mike's there, correct? Is that how that's working?
I don't know how he's going to manage that, but he is requesting more money because the public record law is taking effect January 1st, and it's going to require more time because we have to do it quicker.
All right.
Mary Lou Knight, about how many hours is this expected to evolve, and how many
It's about
public
4 hours a week, maybe. There may be money left over. The idea is I'm not even exactly sure what we're going to see in the oncoming year. But the thing that's concerning to me is the fact that this public records officer that will be delegated to do this kind of request and follow up could be detailed work. I don't know what to expect. But it's going to encompass not just the clerk's office, it's going to encompass other boards within the town hall. That doesn't necessarily mean it's going to go outside of the town hall. I think the police department, fire department, and maybe highway may be doing some of their own, but the catalyst of this is probably going to start in the town clerk's office and then develop with help from other departments.
Do you expect 10, 15 requests a week, 20, 25? I mean, do you have any idea?
Mary Lou, I'm not exactly sure. But I will say this, that this account has been reduced significantly since I became clerk. This was at $4,000 back in 2010. I'll also let you know that in the last couple of years, I've reduced my expense account and another account by $1,400 in the last 2 years, and this is pretty much paid for in that regard.
Just one additional question. How many hours does the assistant work per week now?
Well, it was salaried for about $1,600 for the year, so she pretty much already used that up in from July to now.
Hi, Pete Martell. The only issue is it just seems we went through it a few months ago where another department addressed the public, was trying to address a public need, where the highway department was trying to increase hours for roughly the same time period for a week, 4 hours a week. And the highway superintendent, or highway department rather, produced documents showing, supporting the basis for that. Even the selectman's office produced a document showing in favor of that. There were no documents produced saying why that was a bad idea. And that proposal never even made it to the floor. So I don't know if that's where Herb was leaning towards, but it just seems, you know, this one, there's some that would say it should have gone to an annual and not one of those, but again, it's almost identical in nature that we're trying to provide a service for almost the same thing, same period of time and money, and one never got to town meeting floor, and here we are at a special.
Yeah, the only thing I would address regarding Peter's concern with that is, in regards to this, the account right now is exhausted for the assistant town clerk wages account. The thing is, this is a new law that's going to be implemented January 2017. So, you know, you've got another 6 to 8 months without any money in that account to do any investigative work. And so that's why we're asking for it at a special right now, as opposed to at an annual.
Could I just ask how many requests per week you're averaging now for public records through your office?
It varies, you know. I get sometimes 4, sometimes 2. But the thing is, you know what's going to happen with this public, because public records law that was recently passed by the legislature and was adopted, what we're going to be facing now is probably more scrutiny with public records, because not just the time frame, but there will be more requests, I'm thinking. If there's some anticipation of this, and we got word from town council that they kind of anticipated more public records requests because of the new law. So, you know, this has the support of designated that person to do it, so.
Okay, thank you.
I do have a question to the town clerk. Has there been any discussion amongst the town clerk officials in the state about seeking remuneration from the state for the imposition this places on municipalities? Since there used to be a law in the state of Massachusetts that if you pass a law impacting cities and towns, the state had to provide some aid for that. I don't know if that still exists, but.
Well, there's been some discussion about it. It's, a number of clerks are calling it an unfunded mandate. And, you know, we've seen that throughout the years.
Linda Barron, when was this law enacted, Mike? When was it passed?
It was during the last legislative session.
So since the annual in June?
Yeah, I think. Yeah. I don't have the exact date. I'm sorry.
Okay.
Any other comments, questions, discussion? Okay. If not, all those in favor of transferring the $2,400, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed say no.
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 Ooh, where are my counters? Okay, all those in favor of the transfer, would you please stand? All those opposed, please stand. Four? Okay. The vote passes 31-11. Okay. Article 8. to see if the town will vote to authorize the Veterans Services Officer use of a revolving fund, which shall be credited with receipts from the Commonwealth of Massachusetts Department of Veterans Services reimbursements. Such expenditures not to exceed $10,000 in FY17 or take any action relative thereto.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes, Mrs. Lincoln.
I move that the town vote to pass over this article, and this article will be put on at the annual town meeting warrant.
Second.
Motion made and seconded to pass over the article. Any discussion? No? Okay. All those in favor of passing it over, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, say no. All right, we're moving on to the next article. Article 9, to see if the town will vote, to transfer a sum of money from the planning board clerk salary account to the planning board expense account or take any action relative thereto.
Mr. Moderator.
Mr. Snyder.
I move that the town will vote to transfer $2,000 from the planning board clerk salary account to the planning board expense account. Thank you.
Motion made and seconded to transfer $2,000. Yes, go ahead.
The motion. The purpose of this article is to help fund services of a consultant from the Central Mass Regional Planning Commission who will guide the planning board through a process of reviewing and refining town of Brookfield zoning bylaws. Both the selectmen and advisory committee have recommended the passage of this article.
Okay, any comment, discussion? Okay. All those in favor of transferring the $2,000, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed? Okay, that's a vote. Article 10, to see if the town will vote to allow the Board of Selectmen to use funds from the Town Hall ADA and bathroom account to either renovate the existing bathroom or construct a new bathroom, either of which shall meet ADA compliance.
Mr. Moderator.
Mr. Comtois.
I move that the town vote to amend the action authorized under Article 18 of the June 10th, 2016 annual town meeting warrant to allow the Board of Selectmen to use the funds from the Town Hall ADA and bathroom account to either renovate the existing bathroom or construct a new bathroom, either of which shall meet ADA compliance.
Second.
Okay, motion is made and seconded. Questions, discussion on this one?
Could you tell me what the wording of Article 18 was that we're now amending?
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
It was to allow the Board of Selectmen the authorization to create a new bathroom in the current banquet hall.
And so why is this article necessary? What is the difference?
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
Through discussion...
Before you go, excuse me. Has somebody got a radio on back there, or what's that noise? Coming with?
That's coming from you, Donald.
From you, Donald.
step back.
Back on the second one. Right now. Yeah, it's coming from you. Thank you. Just don't say anything else. Is
he
still there?
No, it's okay.
I think it's his cell phone.
I think he's got two mics live.
Mr. Moderator? Mr. Moderator,
yes.
After this last vote, the board started to work towards installing a new bathroom. Through discussion at Board of Selectmen's meeting, it was brought to our attention that we should contact the state for approval on reconfiguring, which we did. The individual standing behind you and Mr. Snyder met with them. I think Ms. Lincoln was in the room as well. Basically told us that it was not their desire to create a new bathroom unless we had an elevator, basically, literally an elevator in the building for access to the second floor. So this is giving us the ability, and hopefully through the next article, of a plan to move forward with an ADA bathroom in the town hall, which currently we're talking about just renovating the existing bathroom to meet that ADA specification.
So the original Article 18 was for a new bathroom, and this gives you the option to do a renovation rather than construct new.
Correct.
Is that correct?
Correct.
Okay, thank you.
Bruce Clark. There's two parts to this article. One is ADA and one is bathroom. Any reason why we haven't spent a nickel on ADA?
I believe we were going to wait for Tantaswa to come in and do the whole project.
Steve,
Bruce.
Almost a year and a half. Hire a carpenter. ADA.
Well, it's going to cost more than the money that we've allocated to do it all.
It's going to cost us more if we don't start doing something.
Well, we have a plan. Unfortunately, we keep hitting walls.
The ADA is not part of the bathroom. I mean, that's a separate issue.
Well, it is part of the bathroom.
We have doorknobs. We have thresholds. We need to come compliant. Well,
I've met with Tantaswa three times. We've brought them through the building. They've talked about the threshold. We'll have to get a mason for that door on the exterior, the handicap entrance. Mm-hmm. And now we're moving towards, if this passes tonight, the bathroom.
I also sat in on that meeting with Mass Historical. Mass Historical stated the reason they wouldn't allow it in the banquet hall is because we do have another bathroom on the plans, and that happens to be in the assessor's office. They said put that bathroom in first. Then if there's no other place to put another restroom, then we'll allow you, we consider allowing you to break up the banquet hall. That's what they said. They also suggested we hold on to the $50,000 that we had, apply for a grant, and they were very upbeat about the possibility they'd match that $50,000. We have to have the cash in hand. We have to have the architectural design to do restoration, renovation to the town hall. They said they have the money. So
That's the first I've heard. We have both. We have the $50,000 in hand. We have the motion twice. We have the plans.
They won't put in the bathroom, but they'll match the money. We'll still have our money. We're just going to have to wait for their grant to come in, which would be in June, if I remember correctly.
You have to apply.
November.
Have the discussion so I can hear it.
Okay. Back to Bruce, back to Mass Historical money and when it's available.
Right.
That you apply in November.
Right.
But about now they'll be coming out saying, are you interested in applying?
Correct.
February you submit, and correct, then by June you're going to hear.
Right.
So that's, if you're going to go forward, that's the importance of the second article that we'll talk about in a few minutes, is to understand that larger interest as well.
Which is a little misleading, because we're going to spend $50,000 on bathrooms, then give the town hall away. So it is a little bit of a mix in the articles. But I'm still wondering, I totally agree we need two restrooms in the town hall, not just one. And we need ADA compliance. But should we hold on to the $50,000 that we have set aside right now and apply for that grant, since we have the 50 in hand? And see if we can gain another 50 with
it. But do you see, when you criticize in the beginning of this conversation, now you've opened up a different avenue that the board can discuss. You know, we were gung-ho on putting a new bathroom in that hall.
I'm just bringing it to light, Steve.
We brought so many things to light in the year and a half, and this Mass Historical was a major roadblock to me.
Wide open. Yield to Bill.
Hi, Bill Simpson here. I just a quick question on the wording. Does this motion, would this restrict us from using the funds for ADA compliance? The way it's worded, it just says for bathroom or new bathroom existing. I just don't want us to wording that's going to...
It does not. It allows us to do the thresholds, the door, renovate the bathroom. ADA is a broad blanket. Maybe
You can use the funds to either renovate the existing or construct a new bathroom. I just don't want us to... It doesn't say anything about ADA compliance. It says specifically the funds are going to be used for...
What it's doing, the intent of this...
I understand the intent, but the wording is my question.
I want to explain it to the people in the room that aren't as privileged of having the discussions that you've had. We've gone over this twice already. The first motion a couple years ago was to renovate the existing bathroom. Second, there was issue of transparency because we wanted to do a new bathroom through the discussion, so we brought it to the town. You allowed us to put a new bathroom in. Now we're being told by the state that we can't put a new bathroom in unless other hurdles have been jumped. So this is allowing us as a Board of Selectmen to move forward with either renovating the existing bathroom or even possibly putting a new bathroom in, depending on how the wind blows with the state. Grants and...
Is there someone who can answer the question? Will this restrict us from using it for the ADA part of the 50,000 funds?
My interpretation is yes, but I don't make legal sense. The way I read the motion, it does.
It would restrict us from using it for...
If you look at the amended motion, Article 18, from a year ago, install a new ADA bathroom on the first floor of the town hall and to address other ADA issues. This one amends that so that...
Could I make a motion to amend it to include that wording of and to address the other ADA? I don't know. You just said it, but the other ADA access issues in the town hall.
I would second that, Mr. Moderator.
You may make that motion, but you're going to need to go slow.
I have to figure out what it says.
If either one of us requests it, we do, but I'm hoping that this is going to be simple enough.
Yep. To construct either of which meet ADA compliance and to meet the ADA compliance needs of the town hall. Does that work?
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
There is a motion and a second, so through the discussion on this, the article from last year reads, I move that the town vote to amend the action authorized under Article 18 of June 10, 2000. Oh, that's the wrong one, isn't it? Where's the other motion, Karen? That's this year's. Do you have last year's motion? I'm sorry, Mr. Moderator.
Last year's motion
says... The town will vote to transfer some of the money.
$50,000 for the town hall improvements bathroom account, the town hall ADA and bathroom account, all the new ADA bathroom on the first floor of the town hall, and to address other ADA issues in the town hall, parenthesis, threshold and ADA access.
So we can make that motion the same?
And to address other ADA issues in the town hall. I would like to amend it to just say those words, and to address other ADA issues in the town hall.
So that was our error, Mr. Moderator, for not including that.
It's either renovate or construct anew, and then at the end of the statement to address the other ADA compliance
which
issues.
Which
would
be exactly what you read. You have that, Mike?
So at the end of the sentence, we're adding and to address other ADA compliant issues.
Correct.
The first thing we're going to do is go back and discuss that amendment. So I have a second.
Yes, you have a second.
Okay. So any questions adding that amendment to the motion?
Question.
Yep, come on up.
That ADA, that's going to be for the first floor only, right?
Yeah.
We're not going to be throwing in an elevator because of that.
No.
All right, I just want to be sure.
I got a comment. If you all remember when we first brought this to light, we agreed on $40,000 for the bathroom and $10,000 was for the thresholds, handles and doors originally when we first started this thing, and they came to a total of $50,000. So now somehow down the line it's getting a little watered down, and I think that's what we're trying to straighten out now. I don't know if we should put a dollar amount in here tonight or just okay. That'll cover, yeah. Right.
All right, any other discussion on adding the amendment to the motion? All those in favor of adding the amendment to add other ADA compliant issues to this, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, no.
I guess I just want to say that I support this article, and I would encourage the select board to take action as necessary to move this forward.
Anything else? All right, so the motion is to transfer, well, it's to authorize money for the town hall, existing bathroom, construction of a new bathroom, either of which are ADA compliant, and to address other ADA compliant issues. Okay? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, no. Non-binding question.
Mr.
Should the town of Brookfield vacate the town hall for business purposes with a desire to turn the historic building over to the Council on Aging or other town entities for their use, and further construct a town annex for municipal offices and business use?
Mr. Moderator?
Yes, ma'am.
I move that the town of Brookfield take a non-binding vote to vacate the town hall for business purposes with a desire to turn the historic building over to the COA or any other town entity for their use, and further construct a town annex for municipal offices and business use.
Second.
Motion made and seconded.
I would like an explanation for this one.
Mr. Moderator.
Yes, sir.
I'm going to start. This is heartfelt. When I was elected, I remember Mr. Doar questioning me in the banquet hall, asking me what my agenda was, and I had two items. First and foremost was the police station. We've achieved that. Second was the renovation of the town hall. I've been working on that for 6 years. Mr. Simpson's been working on that currently. Mr. Snyder, other selectmen prior to myself, the gentleman that's moderating this meeting worked on it very diligently as well. There's a lot of people in this room that have worked on it. A lot of people at this bank of tables that have a lot of history in that building. I believe it needs to be renovated. But we keep getting tossed back and forth through state discussions, through town discussions. Unfortunately, the whole issue is money. I forget how much money, moderator might refresh my memory. We're talking millions of dollars to renovate that town hall years ago when we were in this room discussing this. We haven't brought it really before the town since then. We have had meetings in the past 6 years since I've been on board to renovate this town hall. It is something that's going to be very expensive, and the Board of Selectmen really want a path of where this town wants to go with that building. So we obviously have the clear path, and we're not spinning our wheels in 10 different directions. So that's my contribution to the discussion.
And so further back to the earlier article, drove us to a discussion with Mass Historical, because years ago you went ahead and you took money from Mass Historical to do the roof. And when you did that, you took a preservation restriction on the building, which forced us to go chat with them or have them come out and chat with us as far as what a minor repair to the building and what a major repair to the building was. And then, as Bruce was talking about earlier, what they would allow or would not allow, what they believe to be historic in nature beyond the building is, in fact, the banquet hall, as it is today, and the upstairs auditorium in the way it should have been, or it is. And so with that, the idea of what the most recent architect that Mass Historical hired for you to come up with a plan, came up with a phased plan, and again, the bottom line number was about $4 million at the end of it, $50,000 to get the thing started, which is something we just talked about, and then it became about a $1 million, $800,000+ to get to an elevator into the building to get to the second floor. That was what your most recent article talked about. And so what they were okay with carving up the banquet hall for additional bathrooms if, in fact, we were going to use the auditorium on the second floor. And really what the question is tonight is, do you really want access to the second floor, to the auditorium, to take advantage of that building? And if you do, then we need to start down a path. And again, I'm looking to Mr. Simpson and yield to him at a moment, because he looks like one of the best grant writers we may have, to see what we could do to kind of move this thing along. Again, when we're talking these sums of money, the best thing we can do is to go find somebody else's money, and where they do have a preservation restriction on us, as it was earlier suggested, taking advantage of Mass Historical would be a good thing to think about in this next round of grants.
I'd like to add a little also, because I sat in on the meeting also, and on the plan that we had, it showed that there would be, when you came into the banquet hall, on the right-hand side, it would be like a hallway going down, and office spaces would be made there, because doors would be made, and he told us that we couldn't do that, because he said that would take away the historical value of the town hall. He said the only thing that we can do in there to make office space would be to put up cubicles that, you know, can be taken, you know, up and down.
Could I just speak to the what our conversation with Mass Historic quickly, and then I have a couple other things I'd like to, I guess, speak about. The Mass Historic's concern was that right now we only have access to the first floor, and the building doesn't have any need. We're not going to hit a capacity that's going to require the additional restrooms until we get to the second floor. If we do have an elevator, then they would be comfortable with us partitioning the first floor in a way that fits the needs of a building with that capacity. So that did come up as part of the discussion. And I guess if the question is, are we going to keep moving forward with the town hall, I just want to, I guess, speak to the story of the progress that we've made at the town hall, starting with we do have a new roof on the building. You know, this is going back a ways. There's been years and years of work going into this. We've got a new roof on the building. We have the most of the entire outside of the building has been repointed over the past 5 or so years. The exterior windows have all been repainted, and they look marvelous. There's a new septic system in the building, and all this has been, we keep making steps forward towards the improvement of the building. And now we have, as the last motion discussed, we have $50,000 to improve the ADA accessibility and install a new bathroom or renovate the old. So that is another step that we've already decided as a town to move forward in fixing up this building. Following on that progress, what the board has asked me to do is to seek the next phase of funding for this project, and that is the elevator that we'd be looking at. And the CDBG grant cycle, we can provide, potentially, if the grants are approved, funding for most of the elevator construction of that $800,000. But it's not going to be a 1 or 2 year fix. This is going to be multiple grant cycles. We need a grant cycle to get the bid documents together, another grant cycle. You know, we're talking 3-5 years to get the then construction plans and pay for the construction. So the way that I've been instructed to move forward, and I think a way that makes sense, because we don't want to eat a $4 million bill, is that we want to proceed slowly, step by step, in a thoughtful way, pursuing all of the grants available, including Mass Historic. And I believe that, you know, in the next handful of years, if the town wants us to keep moving in this direction, that we can get an elevator in the town hall for very little cost to the town, due to the grants that are out there. We may not get the grants the first time around, but I think that's a way to move forward, and that's the way I've been instructed and worked with the board to move forward. So I think the motion as it's written, I would not support it, because it seems to be contrary to that progression that we are already on, and I would encourage the town to vote against this, unless someone can explain to me a reason to vote for it, so that we can continue to move forward on this path. Thank you.
I'm going to try and explain why I think you should move forward. I think it makes more sense to build a municipal office building. You know, it's going to take, if you're going after grants, it's going to take several years. And I think a better plan, a more thoughtful plan, looking towards the future, would be to start some work drawing a plan to build a municipal office building. That said, I think this question should have been put on the ballot at the spring election, so all the people can weigh in it, not just those of us who are here in attendance. And then I have a second comment. I think there's a larger issue. and that's revenue. We keep talking about what we want to get in this town, but we don't have a lot of money. And we need to do something to expand the tax base. I look at all the other towns around us, they have more business. We don't have a Dunkin' Donuts, we don't have a pizza shop. We need to bring more business in the town, and that's the only way we're going to ever have the funds to pay for a new municipal office building or renovating the town hall.
Mr. Cook, I know this is a little bit off the question, but since you brought it up, how do you propose we get more businesses?
All I can say is, having lived in this town for 20 years, we have not always had the most friendly environment towards business. And I think those of us who've been around might be aware of some of the past stories where people have tried to bring business to this town and they've run into obstacles. We need to change the attitude. That starts with the selectmen, and I think they need to work with the other people in this town to encourage more business. That said, we have a lot of obstacles. I mean, we don't have town sewer. We only have water in the center of town. Those are impediments to attracting business. But then I look at West Brookfield, and they don't have sewer, and yet they have a Dunkin' Donuts. So it can be done. But I think we need to start thinking about how we can bring more business to town. And I realize it's difficult.
Mr. Moderator? Unfortunately, as selectmen, we're not really so much in a bubble, but at the same time, we are in a bubble, in a vacuum. We come to a meeting every other week. We obviously, I speak for myself, and I know the other two selectmen are working for this town every single day and whatever activities that we're doing, but we don't have the ability to speak with a group of people like we do this evening. When we have selectmen's meetings, we're lucky if there's two people in that room to voice their opinions. I'm encouraging everyone in this room that feels passionately one way or the other, that's why this article is on here, to come up, form a line, and speak your mind on this issue, because we really need direction. Mr. Cook is right about the tax revenue. It's going to cost the town money. Devil's advocate to Mr. Cook's opinion is that if we vacate the town hall, then we're going to have to find land. We're going to have to find the money to build a new building. There's so many issues either side is, and I'm encouraging everybody to come up and speak their mind about this. Thank you, sir.
So if we decided to abandon the town hall for an annex, wouldn't the town still own the town hall? Wouldn't we then still be responsible for any activities in the town hall? And if it's the Council on Aging, isn't that considered part of our town? So we would then still be responsible for disability access. I'm not seeing we're abandoning this building is in our best interest unless we decide to sell it. And I'm not sure who would buy it unless you want to buy it and move it somewhere. Just kidding. We'll give it to you for a buck. But I don't see the benefit of building an annex. If tragically it were to disappear, that would be a good choice. But I don't think it's going to tragically disappear. We're still going to own that building. It's a beautiful building. Mm-hmm. And like Bill was saying, we've worked steadily towards getting smart things done. The roof, the outside, the windows. Anyone will tell you those are the first things to do. Moving on to the bathrooms, get an elevator in. And slowly, you know, doing the construction to it, I think, makes the most sense.
As one of the people who've worked pretty consistently to renovate the town hall, I feel that's the right direction to continue on. We haven't talked about money in CDBG grants for a senior center in the town hall. I think that the town hall is the center of life in the community. For many, many years, most of the activity in the community occurred in the town hall. We have done without that ability to bring people together in town in common activity for what? 30 years now, 20 years? 20 years at least. We haven't had the use of the upstairs in the town hall. The offices are inadequate in the town hall. We have people working in those offices with very little privacy, people coming in to talk about confidential matters with the town clerk, and everybody's around them. That's not the way to do business in the town hall. When we looked at renovating the town hall before, the number was $2.4 million. Now it's $4 million. The longer that we wait on this, the more expensive it costs us, the more expensive it is to get anything done. So we need to just gird up our loins here and vote to move ahead with the renovation of the town hall. This phased approach seems like it's a good workable arrangement. And in addition to getting the money through CDBG for an elevator, there is money for establishing senior centers in the town hall. And so, to me, the concept is, don't keep spreading us out. That hurts us as a town. We don't come together. We don't know one another very well anymore. And we need a unifying idea, a unifying center to bring people back into the center of town, as opposed to pulling apart the way we have been for the last several years. I certainly support this.
Voting this one down.
Okay. So, in past meetings to discuss this, selling actually was an option that was presented, and I noticed it's left out in this. Whether or not somebody would want it is a whole nother kettle of fish. My old high school in Worcester is now condominiums, so, and it wasn't even a historical building, so. I don't know about the market. Maybe Bob could tell us about the market for those kind of buildings. But the other, so am I to understand then that if this were to go forward, this building would serve as the senior center among other, you know, among community, for community gatherings as well, and then we would still need to build something for offices.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
Those were just ideas that the Board of Selectmen thought of to list for potential use of the building. You have Council of Aging grants that you do have. Mr. O'Connell spoke about including the Council of Aging. Unfortunately, in the new plans that we have, they're not included in that phased in. Is there a room? Is there an office? But there's no really meeting place for it.
There is a meeting.
For a center? Right, because in our original, we had a committee that had basically the whole cellar as a senior center. So it's just a bunch of ideas. Selling the building could be an idea. There's so many things you could think of. But that's, instead of taking a whole page, we just listed a couple items.
Yeah, I'd just like to say, you know, I'm half as old as the building, or a little bit better. The building is older. Even the slates, it's still coming off of the roof. And in my opinion, if you tear it down, put up something new like they did 106 years ago, you'd be better off. Sell the building or do something. Because to go upstairs, and once you put the elevator in, then you got to redo the whole second floor. And the last time that we had a contractor look at it, I think it was $4 million or a little more. He said you still can't insulate it because of the type of brick that the building was built out of. So you can't even insulate the building. So my opinion would be replaced.
Thank you. Mr. Cook?
I want to follow up on Peter's comment because I agree with you. Those offices in the town hall are not really suited to people working there. And that's, to me, the best reason for putting up a new municipal office building. That town hall probably was fine in its day, but I think if you put up a new building, it could be energy efficient, it could be designed with an eye towards the future, towards what, you know, and you could build a building to the specifications of what we think we have now for town needs and what we think we're going to have in the next 20 years. That said, I would still probably keep the old town hall, not sell it. I mean, if you're going to put in the money to do a bathroom, you can still use the first floor for other town activities. And finally, one last comment. Peter, I was here in this town 20 years ago when we voted money for an addition on this elementary school. The sales pitch was that this would be a community center. I don't think that's really happened. I can't really say why, But this building here that we're in now was sold as that.
I've been videotaped, Sharon Mahoney, Long Hill Road. I've been videotaping most of the meetings at which discussions on this issue have taken place, not only by the select board, but by advisory and by Mr. Simpson and other members of the committees that have worked on various capital projects in town. The way this boils down to me is that we have just finished a police station. There was quite a bit of angst about the cost of that. In my book, the project was not only spectacularly successful, but under budget and on time. However, if we build a municipal center for offices, that's going to be another project that is going to be in excess of $1 million because it is a public building. It would be a public building. Not only that, we would have to buy property to put it on, unlike the police station, which was on town-owned property. Finally, there is still the issue, if we want to bring the town hall down, of demolition and disposal costs. We've just put a septic system under this building, and it is designed to work with the town hall and the police station and the highway barn, if I'm not mistaken. So we have overbuilt this septic system with an eye toward hooking in the town hall. That is money that is going to be wasted. So I don't think the proponents of tearing this building, of tearing the town hall down, have taken into account the money that has already been spent on this building, the ramifications, as Peter pointed out, for community life, the fact that an additional municipal building will take another ballot question and cost at least $1 million to build, and then the demolition costs of taking down a building of this size and age. I really think all of those things should be taken into account, and I urge that this body defeat this question. Thank you.
Okay, I think we've been told it would cost us $4 million based on last estimate to renovate the town hall. If it costs us $1 million to put up a municipal office building, that's a $3 million savings to the taxpayer. And that, to me, would be a smart thing to do. I think it would actually cost a little bit more. And as for land, you might not be aware, but the land that this elementary school sits on, there's a whole bunch of land that we own out in Twitchell Grove. There's land out by Lewis Field. So we have adequate land in which we could put another building.
Go ahead.
I'm a little miffed. We're talking about renovating the town hall. I happen to be the chair of the CDBG committee, which is Community Development Block Grants. We're sitting with architects right now doing a senior study. Renovation of the basement is the architect's key focus for monetary purposes. Community Development Block Grants have been totally renovated this year. It's the application process. We are more than likely able to apply this year. I think we better get together as a team and decide what we're going to apply for, because we have infrastructure projects in mind also. And if we're going to go for a major funding for the town hall, we can't do them both. And here we sit at a special town meeting when we were informed a month ago that there are matching funds that we could apply for restoration. There's two words involved. Historical restoration of the town hall, and we're not appropriating your money to match the funds. I don't get it. If we had been up here asking for money to have an account to match the funds Mass Historical would like to give us, it would make sense. But here we sit, we're going to pass on a round of grants for Mass Historical because we didn't put any money aside to match to their money to help renovate or restore the town hall.
Mrs. Wilson, were you going to?
I'd just like to ask the question. Tonight, we're sitting here and obviously having a discussion. about what to do with the town hall. And I think a lot of ideas have been brought forth and a lot of things have been said. And I'm just asking, could I make a motion to pass over this article tonight and then give us the time from here until the annual town meeting to bring this forth when we have better discussion and better things to bring forth and know a little bit more where we're headed. Tonight, when I read how the article was written, it was changed from what I had understood in the beginning. And I'd just like to see us have a little more time, like Bruce has brought up a lot of facts, other people have, and I'd like to make a motion that we take this and pass over it and bring it up to the annual town meeting.
I would second that motion myself with only one concern. Are we going to apply for a grant that has anything to do with the town hall this year? Because we have to do it during the winter months.
I don't know that answer. Maybe they do.
Yeah, can I just speak, Bruce? Back to the Mass Historical money. November, you tell them you want to come. When they send out the next solicitation, you go and apply for February, and then you have until town meeting to
in fact, do the matching.
But they haven't sent out the notice that they're.
Where's the funds, Clarence? Then
Let him finish. Bruce, what you can do is you can put up for February when you submit your plan.
Yes.
And again, I'm saying
yes.
the documents to say that we're interested mm-hmm. would be coming out,
correct.
Which matches with your CBDG meetings that you're about to have as far as the next steps.
Keep going.
You have a meeting on November 30th or
no,
December 1st.
No, that's not what I'm referring to.
Okay, so then what happens is between now, the time that you say you're interested in doing it, till February, mm-hmm. you have a chance to say what you're really interested in doing. And then you submit that stuff. You don't have to have money in your pocket until June.
We do have to hire an architect, and we discussed at that meeting that June money would be too late. We wouldn't be able to appropriate it.
I don't understand.
We wouldn't be able to appropriate matching money in June when he said he would look at our bank account and see whether the money was sitting there.
You can wait.
I was just surprised.
From my past practices with Mass Historical, you don't have to have the money in the bank until you're ready to sign the contract.
Which is June.
Yes.
Which is June.
Yes. And we do have the $50,000. But
I'm just going to go sit down, okay? Because there's no $50,000 tonight. We're spending it on restroom and ADA. We're not setting it aside to apply for the grant. Tell the people that. That's your intention.
You told us that a half hour.
No, I said to you we have the availability.
The moderator had some problems with this non-binding thing to begin with because there was no presentation and the discussion is now going where I was afraid it was going to go. So I need some very new points. Or if you want to come up and say aye or no, but I'm ready to say that unless there's something new, we really need to think about ending this.
I am confused about the prior motion and whether the $50,000 that we voted can or cannot be used as matching. If we're starting to spend it, we cannot use it for matching. Is that correct?
Peter's correct, and Mass Historical anyway. If you spend it, if you've started something, then yes, they won't accept that as matching.
All right.
That's why it's important to have your discussion.
So having had the discussion that we've had tonight with the point that Bruce is making that we need $50,000 unspent in order to qualify for Mass Historical matching, what will the selectmen be doing about the money we just appropriated in the previous article? Are you planning on spending it, or are you now going to enter into discussions with the CDBG committee to figure out what is the right way to go forward?
M-
Mr. Moderator? I would wait till we have that discussion with the CDBG committee. And it seems advantageous to keep that money. There is a plan for ADA accessibility. Tom Hopkins would not have an issue with that moving forward in the town. Getting more bang for our buck is something that we should do in the town of Brookfield, as far as I'm concerned. That's when Mr. Clark started this conversation, why we haven't done anything yet is because we've had these discussions and something new arises every time we have this discussion. Okay. And this would hold us off even more.
Very good. And I would move the question on the current article.
Okay, we're going to end discussion. All those in favor of ending discussion, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed to ending discussion, please say no. Okay, we're going to end the discussion. The vote is on a non-binding question.
We had a motion.
The town of Brookfield vacates the town hall business purposes with a desire to turn the current building over to the Council on Aging or other entity for their use and further construct a town annex for municipal offices and business use. All those in favor of that, please say aye. All those opposed to that, please say no.
No. No.
Motion is defeated. Mr. Martel? Second?
Yes.
There is.
Hi.
So it was unanimous not to vacate.